Honestly, there is no reason for anyone to be obese. And I'm talking about the 99% of you guys that are overweight and out of shape. And I'm not talking about the 1% of people that may have a glandular problem or whatever, genetic. But how can you fix it? Hey there, NJRoot22.com with another low-carb keto carnivore chat. And today's chat is about how fascinated I am by the obesity problem. And they have obesity surgeries and obesity epidemic. You know, they call it an epidemic. But the bottom line is just stop raising your blood sugar, you know? That's it. There's zero to discuss. Your elevated blood sugar is the reason why you get fat. Everybody's obese because they eat the wrong foods. And it's not really about, we could split hairs and talk about all sorts of micro things, but they don't add up. The sum of the rest of this stuff does not add up to a fraction of the fact. The solution is stop raising your blood sugar, period. And it's not about pleasing your taste buds. It's about keeping your body healthy. I mean, I don't understand why that's such a problem. I bet you if I took 100 obese people who volunteered to say, I'm going to live in this compound for a year, all right, and ate what we gave them only, they couldn't have visitors, they couldn't bring in outside food, and blah, blah, blah. 99 out of 100 of them would be not obese at the end of the year. But no one will be willing to do such an extreme thing. They just can't. It's easy for me to say to you guys, it's your fault. It's your fault. And really it is, because you're the only one putting the food in your mouth, chewing it and swallowing it. It's your fault. Really, it really is. There are a lot of things going against people who are obese. And most of the time I like to say it's ignorance. It's ignorance, and they believe the tricky psychological marketing that's thrown out there. But it's 90% of the food available out there, no matter where you go, restaurant, supermarket, you name it, it's bad for you. It literally is bad for you. It makes you eat too much, and it causes you to gain weight. It's that simple. It's addictive, and it's bad for your body. And of course, you know, the marketing, it's like these commercials, they hire professional filmmakers to make the cheese fall off the pizza, and then people eating the bread and they look like they're just like in euphoria. And then of course, the bad science that came around, like, I don't know, in the 70s and the food pyramid and all this other stuff, eat this, eat that, don't eat that, low fat. It was bad science, and I believe, it's my belief, I can't prove it, but it was done by design to enrich people who control the medical industry. It's like they create these sick patients. It's like the freaking, where was that? Purdue Pharmaceuticals. They made the opioids, and then they also made the cure for the, you know, it's like, it's pretty much like that, but on a much larger scale. And of course, these foods that people eat that cause them to gain weight are highly, highly, highly addictive. They're addictive. They're fun to eat. You get this, it's like a dopamine hit on social media. They're fun to eat, and you don't realize it until you don't fit into your clothes or even through the door for that matter anymore. And just imagine this, if you told some people, I guarantee you, you're going to be able to lose, you know, 90% of your weight in like a year or less, but you have to stop eating X, Y, and Z. They're going to be like, oh my God, I'm panicking. And they can't live without those comfort foods they've gotten so accustomed to for so long. It's crazy, and people would rather just die than give up chocolate or pizza or sandwiches or whatever it is that they eat that they love so much. And why do you think lose weight quick scams are always available? You know, late night TV, you'll see some exercise machine or some weight loss pills or whatever, 30 days. They never say, it's going to take you 3 to 5 years to really get back to a good position. And they just don't say that because no one will buy it. They'll see some fat person to do like a bogus before and after picture. And then like, oh yeah, I can do that. Let me send them my $200. And it never works. None of that crap never works. I even, a long time ago, 20 something, 30 years ago, I bought a home exercise machine, and it worked for me somewhat, but you know, home exercise machines, just don't do it. Just be active in other ways. But The whole thing is, no one likes to do hard work or you know, give up the things that they've, you know, unknowingly, literally gotten addicted to, like the foods or the, you know, the drinks. I really think, like, a lot of people that are suffering right now or unhappy or depressed that they're overweight and they're trying every diet under the sun, they really know how to do this, and but they just don't, you know. And the thing I've noticed, and this is great, because people that really, really want to try go through a lot of trials and errors. They'll try one diet, you know, Atkins, and there's all these different diets out there that get popular for one reason or another. And then I've noticed this trend. This is really positive trend. They'll go, you know, like, they'll eat like a low fat diet, and then they'll go to vegan, and then vegan hurts so many people. It really does sap the life out of the people that are really vegan. And then they'll find a paleo, and then they'll go to keto, but they still can't quite get there. And then the people that get there and stay there are on carnivore or a very low carb diet, usually carnivore nowadays. I'm seeing that the carnivore people stay there. When you eat mostly meat, like 99% of the problems go away. You're not hungry, you're not cheating, you're not doing these things. Meat just takes your mind off food. It really does. You eat what you have to eat and you move on and you do other things. It's a beautiful, 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 beautiful thing. But, and I think there are a lot of people out there that think carnivore won't take off because the odds are stacked against them, because there's, you know, marketing and money behind not having that succeed. But the more and more people that, the reason it's going to have a chance, it just may take a little longer, is because the people that do it usually stay there, and for the rest of their lives, so far at least. They'll stay there and they won't screw up. They won't yo-yo. They won't do any of this other stuff like the other diet plans, which are way too complicated and unnecessarily sophisticated than they need to be. But so that's it. And by the way, this is why the whole plant-based thing is, I think, blowing up, because they're trying to cloud and muddy the waters for the carnivore people. And maybe they want to get rid of meat somehow. I think they're going to ban meat in some places, which is utterly ridiculous. And that should be more reason for like a civil war of some kind than any other thing. If you start taking people's food choices away, we got some big, 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 big problems. So that's it. Please hit the like and the subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, please let me know, and visit our website, njroute22.com. See you next video.